morning students, this is Dr. Raimini Hemram, and for today's your Ravik class in the department of in the subject of horticulture, your topic is importance and scope of exotic vegetable cultivation in Jharkhand. So first we'll understand what do you mean by the term exotic. The term exotic means which is of not native in nature or which is not of the same country origin, that thing or that object is known as exotic. So for exotics are those vegetables which has been introduced from other country into the country into other country for its commercial cultivation. So for in India, these exotic vegetables, they are mainly cultivated in Maharashtra, where they are cultivated in places such as Nasik, Pune, Satara, and especially asparagus and broccoli are cultivated in Maharashtra. In Himachal Pradesh, Manali, Kinnaur, Sanj Valley, Sirmaur, Katran, at these places, exotic vegetables like leek, Chinese, cabbage, asparagus, broccoli, lettuce and parsley are cultivated. Apart from these, some private companies are also involved in the production and export of exotic vegetables, which are mainly based in Mumbai and Bangalore area. And the exotic vegetables in which they are involved in production or either export, they are cherry tomato, leek, baby corn and red cabbage. So now we'll see what are the unique features of exotic vegetables which make them so important. First thing is that they can be either eaten raw or they can be semi-cooked. So in that way, their nutrition will not get destroyed. So when we cook the vegetables more, there is a chance that the nutrients which are present in the vegetables, they might get, we might lose them. So when these exotic vegetables, when they are eaten raw or they are semi-cooked, the nutrients which are present in the vegetables, they remain intact. And these exotic vegetables are also highly priced as compared to the traditional vegetables, since they are exotic in nature and as well as they are more highly nutritious as compared to the traditional vegetables. And although the farming efforts are equivalent with the traditional vegetables, the farmers, they will get higher prices for them, for the exotic vegetables. And there are numerous studies of about these exotic vegetables, and they have been scientifically proven as super healthy food. And in 2020 in India, these exotic vegetables market, it has reached up to a volume of 322 million metric tons. So these are some of the examples of exotic vegetables which are either cultivated in India or they have the potential to be cultivated in India. These are asparagus, broccoli, colored capsicum like red bell pepper or yellow bell pepper, cherry tomato and parsley, celery, Chinese cabbage, red cabbage, zucchini and bok choy. Bok choy is also sometimes you may find in literature or somewhere in the internet as bok choy, P-A-K, bok choy. Lettuce, sweet corn, baby corn, Brussels sprout, artichoke, chive and kale. And apart from all these mentioned, whatever vegetables here mentioned in the PPT, there are some more vegetables which have not been included. So next come the economic importance of exotic vegetables. How these exotic vegetables, they hold an importance in the vegetable market, in the current vegetable market scenario. First of all, there is a huge global demand of these exotic vegetables, mainly due to consumer awareness. Nowadays, the lifestyle of people, it has changed, and people, they have become more health conscious, and also their living standards have raised, so they can afford exotic vegetables which comes at higher prices as compared to the traditional vegetables. So because of that, due to that awareness and the health consciousness of people, this global demand for exotic vegetables has increased tremendously. And also as like I said before, that these exotic vegetables, they fetch higher prices than the traditional vegetables. So for farmers, those who are growing these exotic vegetables, they can get higher income on these vegetables. And also the private companies, they are also very much interested for the export, because they will get a huge return from these vegetables and from the export. And so that's why the private companies are also very interested for procuring these vegetables, exotic vegetables from the farmers. If they are growing, they can come into contract farming with private companies or big traders, and they can easily sell to them. Then comes your nutritional importance. So these exotic vegetables, they are proved to be rich in very rich in antioxidants, which is anti-aging property from antioxidants, and they are also highly nutritious. And since they are highly nutritious, they can be a major part of balanced diet. So in that way, the consumption of these exotic vegetables, it can prevent nutritional deficiencies, and it can also reduce the risk of obesity, chronic ailments like diabetes, cardiovascular problems, and even cancer. And since they are either eaten raw or they are semi-cooked, so the nutrients which are present in it are retained. They are not completely destroyed. Then next come your market analysis. So it's very important, because farmers, they take up cultivation, and later on after they get the produce, their produce are ready, they face difficulty for their marketing. So it's very essential that before you start cultivation of exotic market, you should study the market, so that later on the farmer may not face the problem. So for under market analysis, it's obvious that the exotic vegetable market is growing rapidly, and it's a booming economy nowadays. And it has also, as a result of which, it has also attracted corporated houses, or you can say MNCs or private players, to boost their investment. And then there is also a case of a growth in e-retail platforms, e-retail like Amazon or Big Basket, and so because growth in that, everything is going online nowadays. So because of that, the selling of exotic vegetables has become easy. And then also there is a shifting trend towards more organic produce. Those vegetables or those produce which are organically produced, they are more attractive for the consumers, and they also fetch higher prices. Next is these are the list of certain industries like private companies which are involved in the export of exotic vegetable market, either purchase or export of exotic vegetables. So these are Srinath Agrotech Private Limited, then Lawrence Dale Agro Processing India Private Limited, Nisarg Nirman Agro Products Private Limited, SP Vegetables, Anusaya Fresh, Green Earth Fresh Produce Limited. Reliance Retail is it's like very widespread. You can find Reliance Retail everywhere, Reliance Fresh. Then Big Basket, it's e-retail, e-commerce. Then Nature Basket Limited is from Godrej. Then next is your now we can have an idea of how the exotic vegetable market is flourishing in India. First thing first is that right now India is exporting more than 85% of exotic vegetables. So if the consumer, they can get locally grown exotic vegetables, so this import and export, this gap can be reduced. So right now India is importing 85% of its exotic vegetables, and simultaneously the market for exotic vegetables is growing at the rate of 15-20% per annum, and this has become mainly possible due to globalization. And also with the globalization, due to globalization, certain big food chains from other countries, they have come into India, and they have a very good hold on market, like KFC, McD, Subway, Pizza Hut, and another pizza chain is Domino's or Papa John's, like that. So these they have menus which have ingredients in the form of exotic vegetables like lettuce and other things. So since these food chains are so much easily widespread in the country, or even in Ranchi also you can find KFC, McD, Subway, Pizza Hut, Domino's. So there is a scope that they have the market. they are the consumer for the exotic vegetables. And apart from that, some major market for these commodities are five-star or four-star hotels, then fine-dining restaurants, which they cater multi-cuisine, international cuisine, then corporate houses, hospital, air catering even, and in certain places like high-profile marriages, in social functions, you may also find some cuisine which may have exotic vegetables as their ingredients. And then there is another organized food sector, food service sector is also growing in an organized manner. And apart from Reliance Fresh, Nature's Basket from Godrej, and more is also there. Then Big Basket is the online e-retail. And also, as I said before, that there is a high consumer demand for exotic vegetables. So this table includes the list of certain commodities and their prices. And the source for this data is from bigbasket.com. So as you can see, there are many of the exotic vegetable prices, they are around 100 or 200 per kg. For example, broccoli and both the red and yellow bell pepper, they are 100 to 200 kg per kg. Then baby corn also, which is baby corn peel, it is around 200 per kg. Zucchini yellow also, and green lettuce, 250 rupees per kg. Celery, asparagus, leek, bok choy or bok choy, then kale, organically grown, it will fetch more prices, higher prices as compared to traditionally grown vegetables, or even exotic vegetables, if they are chemically grown, their prices will be lesser as compared to the organic. Then romaine lettuce, red lettuce, Brussels sprout, 700 rupees per kg. Means all these vegetables, they are mostly higher prices, more than 100 or 200 rupees per kg. Then based on the place where they can be cultivated, it has been classified into open cultivation or shade net cultivation or polyhouse cultivation. Exotic vegetables, they are mainly cultivated under polyhouse, but there are some vegetables that can be cultivated in open cultivation if the climatic condition is mild in the area. So under open cultivation, exotic vegetables like asparagus, broccoli, red cabbage, parsley, celery, zucchini, lettuce, sweet corn, baby corn, they can be grown easily. Then under shade net cultivation, Chinese cabbage, red cabbage, lettuce, parsley and celery can be grown. And necessarily under polyhouse cultivation, exotic vegetables like red and yellow bell pepper, cherry tomato, these three vegetables are grown. Okay, based on their life cycle, one-time harvest is done in case of lettuce, broccoli, red cabbage, parsley and celery. Like every year it has to be planted. But in case of other crops like asparagus, zucchini, kale, cherry tomato, red and yellow bell pepper, once they are planted, multiple harvest can be taken from these crops as they are perennial in nature. So here I would like to share with you some of the success stories of those farmers, those who have taken up exotic vegetable cultivation. So here is one farmer named Ramesh Verma. He belongs to Kasimpur, Birwa in Lucknow area, and he has a land holding of around 0.5 hectare. Initially he has taken cultivation of broccoli. He procured broccoli seeds from the KVK ICAR, IISR means Indian Institute of Sugarcane Research, Lucknow. He procured broccoli seeds from there, and then he started cultivating broccoli, and he found out that it is giving a lot of return as compared to other rice he had been growing and other normal vegetables. So then he expanded his area and he diversified his exotic vegetable cultivation, and he included other vegetables like parsley, red cabbage, Chinese cabbage and cherry tomato. And he has been selling his produce to multinational retailers and even hotels. So his cost of cultivation was around 26,000, and his gross return was around 3,36,500, so earning him a net profit of rupees 3,10,000 around. And it has been reported that his benefit cost ratio was around 1:11, so that's very huge, means I can say profit for him. And this farmer Ramesh Verma, he has also started training other farmers, and sometimes students from SAUs and other ICR institute, they come to his farm for visit and to gain the insight of how to cultivate this exotic vegetables. So another example, another successful example of exotic vegetable cultivation is from Maharashtra, and it is that Vinca farm. Vinca farm spread across an area of 12 acres, which is operated by Dr. Vilas Kale in Gedegaon, Pune. He started growing asparagus and chive in this area, and he said that he is selling at the rate of 800 rupees per kg, and chive he is selling at 400 rupees per kg, and his monthly income is around 4 lakh rupees. And he's mainly selling them his produce to markets in Mumbai, Delhi or Kolkata. Okay, coming to Jharkhand. In Jharkhand, the Jharkhand State Horticulture Mission, under public-private partnership, has proposed the construction of poly house in Bedo, Ranchi, for the cultivation of exotic vegetables. So it is just now it is being started, or maybe it has started. Then again, the purpose for this project was that the exotic vegetables, it should be grown locally, and so that it will be available at a little bit cheaper rate if they are being procured from other neighboring states or from Delhi, Mumbai, Bangalore. So Jharkhand consumers, they will get it at cheaper rates, and also simultaneously the farmers, they will also be benefited. So for under this at Bedo, the proposed exotic vegetables which is to be grown, they are asparagus, Brussels sprout, Chinese cabbage and broccoli, red cabbage, baby corn, lettuce, parsley and mini cucumber. So this was reported in Jharkhand Telegraph in 2014. And another farmer or innovative farmer, I can say, is Rakesh Mahanti. He is from Patamda, Jamshedpur. So he started organic cultivation, and along with protected cultivation of exotic vegetable like lettuce. He was particularly focused on lettuce. So he has also said that exotic vegetable is very successful, and he is a passer from Accelerize Jamshedpur, and he is also training students and other farmers, those who are interested in exotic vegetable cultivation. So this report was also given in Jharkhand Telegraph, as you can see, dated 26 December 2019. Now, apart from all these, in spite of that, there are certain problems with exotic vegetable cultivation. There is always pros and cons about anything. So we'll see what is the problem with exotic vegetable. The method of farming, or especially selling of exotic vegetables, it differs from typical farming. For example, like, you cannot go and sell exotic vegetables in Haat or mandis, because still at local level, those who go to mandi or Haat, places for purchase of vegetables, they might not know that these vegetables are highly nutritious, because they will be offended by the high prices for those vegetables. So selling of those exotic vegetables are a little bit tricky. So you have to be well prepared, or you have to be in contract farming with the big players like the e-retailers or the private companies. So just to make sure your produce don't go waste after it is ready for marketing. Then also skilled labor is required since the method of farm, means skilled labor is required mainly because most of these exotic vegetables are cultivated under protected cultivation and leaving few. So they are trained, means knowledge is required, skill is required. So the labor, he has to undergo training or he has to contact scientists from ICR Institute before he commences exotic vegetable cultivation. Next is production productivity of exotic vegetables. Most of the exotic vegetables are comparatively low from the traditional vegetables. And then next, it has to be cultivated under protected cultivation. That is a must, except a few. And then there is also lack of proper market. Proper market in the sense that still these vegetables cannot be sold in open market. You might find these vegetables in Reliance Mart, More, Nature Basket, in these supermarkets you might find it, but in open market you might not find exotic vegetables, or even if they are available, public may feel hesitant to purchase at such a higher rate, although it deserves, exotic vegetable deserve that price. Then also the high cost of seed, the planting seed material availability. Some of the seeds like broccoli and Brussels sprout, they may be available with the ICR Institute, but still there are exotic vegetables whose planting material seeds, mainly seeds, they have to be imported from outside country. Then there is lack of research. Academic research levels are not, you might not find much of academic research in exotic vegetables in the country. So to overcome these problems, suggestions have also been put up, like for awareness, for providing awareness, for generating awareness and providing training to the growers. These are the duty of SAUs and ICR Institute. Even the progressive farmers or the innovative farmers who have taken up exotic vegetable cultivation, and they have found it is very profitable enterprise. So they are also training the interested candidates. And also there is need for the development of cost-effective production technology, mainly like low cost poly houses, shade net, like that. And there is also a need for the establishment of proper market. So this is also, this depends on the consumer awareness, and also quality procurement of quality seed material. That is also very crucial, and it can be fulfilled if the seeds are procured from the ICR Institute or from the trusted government nurseries. Then developing of improved varieties with desirable traits like yield, resistance to biotic and abiotic stress, and qualitative traits. So these improved varieties needs to be developed based on your agroclimatic features of a particular region, like for example for Jharkhand or any other particular place. So seeds of lettuce, leek, broccoli, Chinese cabbage, these are available with the IRI research station at Catran or Kullu or University of Horticulture and Forestry, NONI. So seeds of these are available, otherwise for other vegetables it has to be imported from other countries, or you can purchase it from the private companies. So at last, in conclusion, it is that we can conclude that growing of exotic vegetables is dependent on climatic conditions and also highly on the consumer preference of the region in particular. And there is also a great scope and opportunities for these crops in the region due to urbanization and also the change in lifestyle, food habit, consumer awareness. They have become more health conscious, and the increase in fast food restaurants, and then awareness for the highly nutritive vegetables or fruits, and also high profit in growing these vegetables. Then also it is important to improve the cultivation technology, so to cut down the cost, and for the adoption of for higher production of exotic vegetables without hampering its quality, to meet the demand of the consumer. So that's all for this lecture. Thank you.